Reverend Wendy Hamilton is a minister, a mother, a counselor, and a friend. Reverend Wendy Hamilton is a small town girl from Midwestern Ohio who came all the way to Washington, D.C. to attend the Howard University and decided to stay here and make a life. I think my greatest passion is in helping others pursue and find their purpose. I love people. I'm a Libra, so I love harmony. And so just part of my personality is really what led me even to ministry. You can't help but live in D.C. and get involved in some measure of politics. So my deepest involvement up to this point was with the Obama campaign, just doing some call center work, did some outreach. But politics for me was always an interest because of the social justice aspect.
It's up to you to flush the pipes clean and retake our government so it starts working for us and not the corporate interests in 20 short days. Thank you very much, Ames.
One morning in 2018, you know, I was reading the New York Times and saw an article entitled "The Robots Are Coming." And it was actually introducing Andrew Yang, who had just recently declared for the presidency of the United States. Article was talking about the threats of automation. And that hit home right away with me because all I could think about was my grandfather and how their jobs got automated away or shipped overseas. And they had nothing to fall back on, nor did they have a fallback plan. Andrew was talking about we need to do something to help people, give them a lifeline. We need to recognize people are struggling. So he proposed the idea of a universal basic income of $1,000 a month to each and every American because it's what we deserve. It's a part of our birthright. It's not a handout, it's a help out. And so I thought to myself, that $1,000 would have made a tremendous difference to my grandmother or my grandfather when we were going through those tough times. So an average day for myself as the Director of Spiritual and Cultural Outreach for presidential candidate Andrew Yang involves outreach. It involves meeting. It involves some travel with the campaign and talking with faith leaders about how Andrew Yang's platform resonates within faith communities in particular. That's what drew me to this campaign. It's one of the things Andrew did before he started running for president is he started a nonprofit, Venture for America. He had decided he was going to go into Baltimore and Milwaukee and Detroit and set up entrepreneurship programs for people in distressed areas to help give them a leg up. So Andrew's not just telling you something to get in the office, he's got receipts. Dave Chappelle endorsed us. People don't necessarily vote because a celebrity is endorsing someone, but it does give someone a moment to pause and reflect and say, if that celebrity is endorsing, I gotta check this out. And that's what I've been seeing playing out on social media. Like, hold up, Dave Chappelle is one of the most conscious brothers out there. If Dave Chappelle is willing to endorse Andrew Yang, I might have to give him a second look. I believe this is the candidate that is going to beat Trump because if you look across the board of supporters for Andrew Yang, you're going to see Democrats, Republicans, libertarians, and, you know, even some of the Trump voters that I encounter on the trail, they'll say, I was a former Republican, I voted for Trump and was about to vote for him before, but this guy right here, he hears us, he's genuine, he's authentic, and that is the exact opposite of what we have now. And I believe as a country, we're yearning to get back to that.